Take a look at what it looks like on the ground in the Dominican Republic this morning. There it is. That's just the outer bands of the hurricane. It is not going to be a direct hit on the Dominican Republic, but you can see how powerful those winds are.
And those first images of the storm's power, George, they're extremely scary. Just listen to it. And also this morning, we're seeing so much destruction already, and hopefully everyone is evacuated and safe.
That's right, Michael. So far, the Category 5 storm has killed at least 10 people. Winds are now 180 miles an hour. States of emergency have been declared in Puerto Rico and Florida and parts of Georgia and South Carolina as well. The Hurricane Center says a direct hit in South Florida is likely. Amy is live in Miami, and she'll have more just ahead.
Now, we want to look at the traffic there this morning. There you see the highways in South Florida right now. Mandatory evacuations have been ordered in much of the southern part of the state. And we have team coverage from Puerto Rico all through Florida. Chief Meteorologist Ginger G starts us off with the latest on Irma's path. Good morning, Ginger.
Good morning, George. Hurricane Irma can now be said to be the strongest for the longest period of time on the globe. That is a huge statistic that brings us to the power of Irma. And you can see it moving away from Puerto Rico now and toward the Turks and Caicos. Those would be the next in the direct line. Dominican Republic will certainly be brushed as that more ragged eye moves north, but west and northwest is the general trend, and that's why we see hurricane warnings for surge up to 20 feet in places like Turks and Caicos and the southern Bahamas. Now we've got a hurricane watch that includes Freeport and Nassau, and of course it will brush just a bit with tropical storm force winds for Cuba. Now, I want to watch this track with you because this is what everyone's interested in, the timing. It's tonight through early tomorrow that Turks and Caicos, southern Bahamas gets hit. Then it's Saturday into Sunday when it starts to close in on the Florida Keys. It's Sunday night into Monday as we move through the southeast portion of Florida. This cone now reaches all the way into South Carolina, Charlotte's included. Lindsay Janis has been watching the storm from Puerto